A very good morning to you. How are you doing? This is Life and Style and Merry Christmas. Yes, we say this every single day, just in case no one is telling you. So have a merry, 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 merry Christmas. I hope you're feeling good and feeling alive. Today is Inspirational Thursday. And you know what we do? We help you become a better person. We educate you. We motivate you. We inspire you. We're all about that. Now, Tendai is joining me on the couch today.
It feels good to be here.
It feels good.
You know, I mean, I didn't know this is the comfort you're experiencing this
time. Now you understand why we love it
here.
Yeah,
I mean, luxurious and everything.
You torture us. You have to start. You know. Anyway, so you brought a guitar, and we're going to start Innovate from here today.
True, that's something different this entire.
So are you going to?
Yes.
I'm trying to see what's techy about it.
That's the part I'm getting to. So we have a guitar here, which I'll get into in a moment.
Okay.
But many people who aspire to learn how to play the guitar, and even people who actually know, have one problem: tuning a guitar. You know, when you want to give like really good, a good performance, the guitar has to be tuned to the perfect tightening or looseness of the strings. And there's this application which I managed to stumble upon. It is called Guitar Tuner.
Guitar Tuner?
Yeah.
It's actually, I know.
I was shocked as well, because then I said, I'm like, what do you mean it tunes a guitar?
Okay.
So, until when I finally actually got to learn. So, basically what happens is you play a chord on the guitar, or rather a string, and it'll tell you if it's in tune, if it's in sync or not. And then
so
basically
you'll figure out what string you're playing.
Yeah, yeah, imagine. That's another cool part about it. You'll figure out which string you're playing automatically. So the moment you do so, there's this little like graph, if you can see. It's supposed to go green. If it's green, you're good. If it's red, you're not good. So you're supposed to just tune until you find that
green place.
It's like the sweet spot.
Whoa.
Yeah, so I want to give it a test to see exactly if the difference between a tuned and untuned guitar.
All right.
So I would want you to hold
that
over there.
Okay, let me just hold this. And then you play.
And I play it. Disclaimer. Disclaimer, I do not know how to play the guitar, to be quite honest. That's it. There's no other way. But it's tuning, right? Maybe I can do a couple of tunes there.
All right.
So basically, we'll just start from the top going to the bottom and seeing if it'll actually project the right tune.
Okay. It says too low.
It says too low, yeah? So basically, I'm gonna have to just tighten it.
There you go.
And actually gives you a click, so that's a perfect
E. It tells you that's a perfect E.
Yeah, it's a perfect E.
Okay.
So we go to the next one, which is A, and it's too what? It's too low, right?
Yeah.
So, again.
There you go.
And you go on. So basically that's how, isn't this not much easier? Especially if you don't have the ear of a professional. That's good.
That's perfect. Perfect.
We're doing pretty well. So basically, it's a fully tuned guitar.
Oh my god.
So this application is absolutely helpful, especially if you are in the learning phases of learning how to play the guitar.
Okay.
And of course, it does have little lessons to teach you how to play the guitar, you know, some easy chords. In fact, before I actually came up, do you know, I managed to learn a couple of things.
Oh, okay, you did?
Yeah, I mean,
so you're going to show off right here.
Well, I can't say showing off because...
You're still learning.
Because I'm still learning, but you know, we can give it a go. Yeah.
Okay. So, do you want to introduce what you're going to play?
Yeah, this is very odd. So, there's this song called Africa Unite by Bob Marley. Probably you might have known it.
I know you love Bob Marley.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Huge fan as well. So, I'll just do like a small little part as far as I can go. Okay. Disclaimer, it won't be perfect.
I hope we get to even get the tune.
I hope so too.
Okay.
Now, the holding strings is not an easy thing, yeah? Africa unite, you say Africa unite, yeah. Africa unite, cause we're moving right out of Babylon and we're grooving to our father's land. How good and how pleasant it would be before God and man, we're to see the unification of all Rastaman. has it been said already? Let it be done. I'll tell ya who we are under the sun. We are the children of the Rasta man. Ooh. We are the children of the higher man.
Tonight, I know I've teased you about singing the last time we did a jam together. You remember?
It's funny, that was just last week, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, you know.
Wow, so, you can actually sing and play that one song.
No.
that one song. I didn't say.
No, one song.
That one song.
So the application again is called Guitar Tuner.
Okay.
So if you want to basically just know how to basically tune your guitar to the perfect.
If you want to have Tendai sing again.
I'm having a strange deja vu moment right now.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, I feel like we've done this exactly before.
Remember to keep this conversation going on our social media platforms, KTL Life and Style. What do you think about Tendai?
Oh, yeah.
Like, is he good? Can he better his game? I think you did amazing.
Oh, thank you.
Wow,
that was my first time playing like in front of like more than one person.
I know.
So yeah, I mean, so that's a great app. So it's called Guitar Tuner. If you want to tune your guitar or learn a couple of chords here and there.
And it's free.
And it's free. So it's the best way to go.
Ooh.
Yeah. So apart from the musical aspect.
I'm still stuck on this. It's okay. Fine. Moving on.
So apart from the musical aspect, we have something that's rather interesting.
Mm-hmm.
It is both extremely healthy. I mean, nowadays people should have that embracing of living a much more healthy lifestyle.
Yeah.
And the best thing about it is when we get to find ways to do so. So I'm going to move over to this side and you're going to have to see what's pretty interesting, pretty nifty. I'm sure you'll love it.
Okay.
Yeah?
All right.
So thank you for hosting me at this corner.
Yes.
I'll leave you here strumming the guitar.
Hey. I can't even hold it. Bye tonight.
Hi, Mikali. Hello, sir. I got to hear about this contraption and I really love the mass that goes into it and what it produces. But maybe you can start off by introducing yourself and then we can get deep into what we have here today.
Okay, my name is Wanjala Manyoni Naserende. I work for CARO, Kenya Agricultural and Livestock Research Organization, which has 16 institutes, research institutes.
Around the country.
And now, this is under AMRI. AMRI is an acronym for Agricultural Mechanization Research Institute.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a bit complex. This crop is grown by CARO Njoro.
Which crop?
The one that I have here is canola.
Oh, can we
canola?
We have a look at it.
This is canola.
Canola.
Yeah.
It's a grain, yeah?
It's a grain.
I see.
Seed.
Okay.
Yeah. Uh-huh. From which we extract oil.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But we brought in this canola just because we did not have time to bring in the avocado, which was the main subject for the day.
Oh, so ideally normally use avocado?
Yeah.
Okay, I see.
Because of its benefits,
mm-hmm,
and the problems. Actually, our purpose is to solve a farmer's problems. Mm-hmm. So we look for problems and solve them. That's what the definition of agriculture engineering is.
I see.
Yeah.
So this is agriculture engineering.
Yes.
All right. So just a quick explanation again. Define agriculture engineering.
Okay. Agriculture engineering is the application of agricultural aspects,
mm-hmm,
in production of food, that is livestock
and crops.
Yeah.
So this time we are on the crops aspect of the engineering, right?
Even livestock, because the cake will go to the livestock.
Which
and
cake?
The oil, the cake is the refuse.
Or the residue from after the extraction of the oil.
And the oil will go to the human as food.
Ah, wow. That's amazing.
Yeah.
So are we able to set it up and we try seeing how we can, you know, go about it?
We can.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So I see this piece is out. I'm presuming this is supposed to go there?
This is a handle,
mm-hmm,
for leverage.
I see.
It's fixed here.
It's pretty heavy duty machine, isn't it?
It is.
Perhaps maybe you can explain to us what's going to happen.
Now, maybe I go back a little and talk about why this came about.
Mm-hmm.
It's that some people are not able to access the imported oil, the synthetics, the high level. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So what we do, We do a kitchen industry where one person in a village or in a two or three villages can own this and produce oil for sale and make a living. You will also create jobs for young people.
What type of crops or what can you put inside to produce this oil?
There are actually many. Mm-hmm. We call them oil crops. Just to name a few, mm-hmm. we have canola, have sunflower, we have sesame, groundnuts, and now avocado, which is now the most important, and that's the actual thing for the innovative day today.
So maybe you can explain to us how you ideally extract the oil from avocado.
Avocado.
Because I mean, I've heard from sesame seeds, I have an idea, but avocado is a unique one. So maybe you can tell us the process on it.
Avocado is difficult to handle. Mm. What I'm talking about is actually the problem before I solve it. Yeah. It's difficult to handle.
In terms
it's
of
high yielding, it ripes at the same time. You can't eat all.
Yeah, true.
Transportation might cost more than
the
material you are transporting.
Yeah.
So you need to utilize it where it is, but it's too much. If you go to places like Vihiga, like Chuka, like Moranga, you find avocados are for livestock. It's eaten by dogs and cattle.
Is it because there's an abundance?
Because you can't finish.
It's just
and
there.
There's no way of utilizing them.
Yeah.
So there is a way of solving the problem. Because you know that masking your face with avocado has some meaning to the beauticians. So we look at what is it in that avocado that makes people mask their faces with. So we go for the active ingredient, which can be extracted by this oil press or ram press or oil extractor, whichever name.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So we cut raw avocado.
Mm-hmm. Also not ripe yet.
If it's ripe, it's difficult to handle.
Because it's, I understand.
It's difficult to handle. So it has to be raw, just about to ripe, but before. Mm-hmm. Then slice pieces that can drop in our aperture here.
Yeah.
Then you dry using solar. You can use a solar dryer, which we have also made. We've innovated.
Wow.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We use it for vegetables and even avocado. Mm-hmm. When they are dry, in 3 to 5 days, we put the pieces here. Then you ram. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Ramming is actually squeezing through this chamber. If you open, it enters, you put it back, it squeezes it. So it will expel most of the void, the viscous, the material, like water, oil, and air.
Out of it.
Out of the material. So the solid material will come out as cake on this side, and the liquid material will come out as oil on this side. Harvested, yeah.
Wow.
Now, what you harvest here is not clean. Mm-hmm. So you need another process, which is filtration. It is very simple. Just get a cloth, hang it up, and then a container. Through gravity, you'll get your clean oil. It's filtered.
I understand.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. The avocado oil is important because as much as avocado itself is low valued, its oil is highly valued because of use in soap manufacture, cosmetics, and as cooking
as well, isn't
it?
So all those are really good oils to actually cook with.
But
all right, so can we pour in some seeds right now to actually try to start the compression session?
Okay, let me call a helper so that when I pour, he can assist me.
With the lever,
Mr. Mbugwa.
Mr. Mbugwa,
come.
Please join us.
This is sunflower seed.
This is sunflower seeds, yeah?
Yeah.
Mm. Wow. They're actually quite bigger than I thought they would be, you know? So I know sunflower seeds are chock full of oil, isn't it? So we can start. Mm. So as he's moving back and forth, it's falling into the tube, isn't it?
Actually, when he raises it like that, yeah, it's loading.
It's loading.
Yeah. Then when he compresses, it squeezes out.
Squeezes out the so oil. From this side, this is like the cake.
This is the cake, uh-huh, on this side.
No oil whatsoever in this.
Very little, the remnants.
Remaining here.
Yeah. And then the other oil comes through this.
It's actually oozing through everywhere, from what I'm seeing, isn't it?
Yeah, it oozes through everywhere.
Yeah, but collects and to this is channeled side there.
Yeah. You can see it dripping now.
Yeah, look at that. Yeah. Just like gold. So you just fidget with it a bit while the others reload, isn't it?
Yeah.
Amazing. So you mentioned, apart from sunflower seeds, which other crops could you use to
produce this? We had canola, mm-hmm, we have sunflower, mm-hmm, we have sesame, mm-hmm, we have groundnut, mm-hmm, we have avocado, we have walnut.
Walnut, yes.
We have macadamia.
Wow.
We have agon.
I'm trying to imagine pouring macadamia nut in this and squeezing it out.
But you prefer maybe eating a whole macadamia than squeezing the oil.
Yeah.
So, it's rich in some. What I'm naming, mm-hmm, have similarities, mm-hmm, in their type of oil.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. They are from common.
Yeah,
common
they grounds, can be used for cosmetics and soap.
I see.
And can also use for cooking.
Well, the oil which is collected?
Yes.
Oh yeah, it can be used for
it's
cosmetics.
It's actually industrial.
Is that so?
Yeah.
So,
industrial additive.
Can you give us an example of what it would be used in an industrial type of setup?
If you go to any supermarket, you'll find like
Mr. Mbugo,
a product.
Thanks so much. Huh? I can see the gold flowing through. Look at that.
Yeah.
Hit the jackpot, haven't you, now,
Yeah.
So that's what I'm completely saying. And how much sesame seeds do you need to make, let's say, a normal 500 milligram bottle?
It's normally by volume. Mm-hmm. By volume. Every one produces a quarter.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Every one what? Seed?
Every one volume
of
sesame, uh-huh, will produce one quarter.
What is defined by volume? How much is a volume?
Okay, if you have, let me put it this way.
Mm-hmm.
If you have four of these containers,
uh-huh,
yeah?
Yes.
You can only squeeze one full.
I see. So it's like a 1-4 type of thing.
One in four.
One in four.
Yes.
I see. And you said it can last on shelf life for how long?
3 months.
3 months.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
This is definitely a healthier option, right?
It is.
Mm-hmm.
And even it has capacity to reduce, if it was from avocado,
mm-hmm,
capacity to reduce cholesterol levels.
In the body. Wow. Yeah. That's amazing. Yeah. And it goes through the same process.
Yeah.
So this cake now, you had mentioned, this is now what you'd give to, it's like animal feed,
livestock,
right?
Yes.
What you mentioned, like kettle?
Yeah.
Yeah, which would be great for, yeah? So nothing goes to waste?
It's cost effective to give it to kettle because it increases the milk production.
Mm-hmm.
But if you gave it like to a non-milk producing animal, it would, mm-hmm, be a waste.
Oh, if it's I understand, yeah, because of all the nutrients in it,
the
I can
value
imagine
of it, yeah.
Okay, all right then. Yes. So the oil is still dripping out.
Yeah.
I can still see.
Yes.
And now after, if it, technically, if we had gone on and on and putting more and more buckets, yeah, it would increase much more in volume.
It will be a continuous stream.
Yeah. Of oil, isn't it, coming out? The filtration process is not something that's too difficult. I don't think so, right? Because it's just a matter of filtering it, isn't it?
Now there is a cloth.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You know the perforation through a cloth is very small, so that these particles cannot pass.
Mm-hmm.
It's only liquid that can pass.
Mm-hmm.
So you hang it up.
Ah, there's like a cloth, isn't it?
Yes, under.
Okay. And,
but at the top, mm-hmm, there is a container, uh-huh, which you have a lot of liquid.
Yes.
You pour there, and since it takes a long time, normally we recommend overnight.
Overnight.
You just put it there, then go and sleep. When you come in the morning,
you have your bucket of your oil. Yeah, filtered to go.
For whatever target market.
And of course you can use this on anything, right?
Yeah.
You mentioned that people use for cosmetics.
Yes.
How I would want to know how you now come into play for that. Do you supply any particular cosmetic industries? And maybe you can give us examples of where this is being used right now.
Now, I said, I am a researcher.
Mm-hmm.
I come up with an idea.
Mm-hmm.
Then the business people should take up that as an innovation. Because even this machine is innovated as a design, then given to manufacturers to do that work. Yes. As we proceed to do other research. Identifying problems and solving
the
problem,
then you move on to the. So like this now, you're just given this concept to now the
people. Yeah, the now the manufacturers are the ones
they're using this. Well, I think it's a very great machine, and I think it definitely is that if you want more healthier oil, you know, like the avocado, like you mentioned, I think this is one of the best options we can find, isn't it not?
Yeah.
Perfect. This has really been amazing. So how could someone easily acquire this? Let's say someone's doing like farming. How could they get in touch to actually, you know, obtain this?
It's actually called a ram press.
Ram press,
or
yeah.
Oil press. Mm-hmm. It can be found in most of the agrovets, like KFA, like any mayor, all these agro shops, they have this machine. Yeah, it goes for between 30,000 and 40,000.
This particular one?
Yeah.
Ah, okay. So around 34,000, you have your oil maker.
Yeah.
And who is your target market for this? Is it individuals, for example, or is it like, you know, industries like farms? Who is the targeted buyer?
The target is individual.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So you mean I could get this for myself?
Yeah.
Yeah? I don't
know. This one is individual. So? If you go for commercial, you need a higher output. You know, you can do about 20 liters in a day.
Wow.
And if it's commercial and you are employing many people, you may not be able to pay. Mm. Actually, per day, it's estimated to give you like not about 20 liters. Mm-hmm. And in a month net, you'll have like 18,000 or 20.
Wow.
Yeah. So if you are in a village, that's big money.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So this way, this would fly off the shelves. Yeah. Amazing. This is pretty cool.
Yeah.
Thank you for you guys coming and actually showing us this piece of hardware. And I think it's definitely a look at finding, I mean, I've seen oil be made live, basically, you know. So I guess this is the cleanest oil without other impurities once it's been strained out. It's pure gold oil from sunflower seeds.
Yeah.
Amazing. Thank you so much. I really appreciate for you guys coming and showing us this. Thanks. So much.
Thanks.
Great having you on the show.
Thanks.
All right, guys. I mean, that is basically it. That is the, it compresses basically all type of veggies or other seeds that have oil and gives you oil. And I guess it's the much more cleaner option since, of course, it has growth. So vegetable oil for you. Tell us what you think, of course, on our social media platforms. And tell us, you know, what do you think of this piece of technology? It's good. It was made here and it's definitely helping a bunch of people. But otherwise, right now, we're going on a short break. But we'll be right back with Motivate. So stay tuned for that.
We had to put this to an end. We had to find a solution. And if it came to that, I knew there was no going back.
Chronic illnesses are just a mental battle. Because now you're wondering, what next? What if I die?